What's white privilege? I want to learn. I want to learn.
Stop.
I'm not racist. I have black friends.
Grown men and women with degrees and life experience, they say stupid shit like this. I can't understand it.
See, someone online, someone's convincing people that the only way to be racist is to literally refuse to associate with people of color. And that a racist is a three-headed beast with beady little eyes and sharp fangs that spits venom at you from 10 feet away. I'm not sure where you got this impression. See, here's the thing. If somebody accuses you of being racist, it's because you did or said something racist. It has nothing to do with who you voted for, who you went to prom with, what kind of people you associate with, what kind of shows you watch, what kind of people you hang out with, who your friends are, watch, what kind of music you listen to. It has nothing to do with that. It's because you did or said something that was racist. So do me a solid, don't bring these things up when somebody calls out one of your questionable actions. Don't bring them up because they're utterly irrelevant. I mean, I'm sure your black friend wouldn't be very happy if they found out that you were using them as your get out of racist accusations free card. The next time somebody says of your actions, that was racist. Stop. Think. Listen to what they have to say. Consider the possibility that a person of color might just know more about racism than you could ever hope to imagine, and simply by virtue of the fact that they're not white. The final step is to try your very best not to do it again. That's it. That's all. There is no detox. You will not be banished. There's no prison term. You don't have to pay a fine. You don't have to change your self-concept. Just try your very best not to do it again. And that's it.
Yeah.
At first, when they came to me and he said he wanted me to present the award for Best Picture, my management came and they told me that the Academy had picked me in. And my first reaction was to say, no, I ain't going. And I said, my manager said, but why? Like a white manager said, I talked. But why? And I said, I said, I'm not going because they haven't recognized black people in the motion picture industry. What are you talking about? Black people won Oscars. I said, well, black actors and actresses that won Oscars throughout 60 years was like, I think Hattie McDaniel won the first one, then Sidney Poitier won one, and Lou Gossett won one. And I'll probably never win an Oscar for saying this, but hey, what the hey, I gotta say it. Actually, I might not be in any trouble because the way it's been going is about every 20 years we get one, so we ain't due for about 2004, so. By that time, this was all blown over. I said I wasn't going, and my manager said, you just have to go, you can't snub the Academy. So I came down here to give the award. I said, but I just feel that we have to be recognized as a people. I just want you to know I'm gonna give this award, but black people will not ride the caboose of society, and we will not bring up the rear anymore. I want you to recognize us. He said, well, fine, it's done. I said, now, when do I have to be there? He said, well, you don't have to get there until about 9 or 10, because it's the last award of the evening. So, I'm hearing that.
But that's not racist.
No, you copped that new Justin Bieber album.
Oh, dog,
the acoustic version though.
Number 9.
Yeah.
Oh.
For real,
dude. I'm so sorry. Please, here. You can have my wallet. You can take whatever. I have food stamps in there. You can probably get watermelons, grape drink. I'm sorry. Just leave me alone. Fried it. You can have fried everything in there. I'm so sorry.
But that's not racist.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to.
Bro,
I didn't mean to.
Hey, it's all good. Yeah. It's all good.
It's really not that serious.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm serious.
All right, brothers.
Calm down. Just calm down.
Man, some people could just be so racist all the time.
Oh my God.
Wait, I love Allah.
But that's not racist.
All right, guys. Following back here. Why don't you put that table right? Hey, try not to hit the doors. Put the table right over there.
No, yeah. Really?
I'm gonna hit this door if
I want to.
Oh.
Just because you're white, you can't tell me what to do.
No. Man, we're not your slaves.
No,
you want to be my master?
No, not at all.
Master! Cracker!
But that's not racist.
You watch Game of Thrones.
Game of Thrones is my shit.
Man, that's what I love about you. It's like you're a black dude, but you don't act black.
What?
What I mean is, like, you don't act all, like thugged out.
Oh, so all black people are thugged out?
Man. Oops, I was racist. Black guy, come here.
How can I help you?
I was trying to bond with my black coworker, but things got racist real fast.
Hey, man, he's all right. He's a really good guy. What he meant to say was that he finds it extremely refreshing that you managed to somehow defy racial stereotypes, right, remain your own person, rooted but not bound to the black experience, which is culturally astonishing for him because he comes from Milwaukee and his father's a redneck.
He said all that.
He's cool, man. He ain't got a mom to your house all the time, man. Eat, place,
food. Lover. It's good food.
Good guy.
Okay, if you say so.
Thank God for racism insurance.
there when you need it most. Racism insurance.
I'm not racist, I have black friends.
For black people who are in environments of mostly white people, maybe, or mostly non-black people, but I think especially white people, we could be talking about school, about the workplace, about some sort of organized activity like sports. You have a special role to play, and we've understood in society that black is kind of cool. Black got us jazz and hip hop and all kinds of sports accolades and entertainment, and that's well and good, and white people kind of often feel better, feel like it acknowledges them as open-minded people, as progressive people, to say, it's really cool, I got this black friend, and therefore I'm not racist, therefore I'm more plugged in, therefore I know what's hip. What is less celebrated or understood is what the black friend can do and has done historically for the black community. And we think often of great civil rights leaders, we think of people who marched in the streets and sacrificed. We rarely think of the quiet diplomatic efforts of the black friend, who was friends with white people, who answered their questions, who prevented racial conflagrations, maybe even riots, by simply saying, no, white friend, you can't say the N-word. No, white friend, please don't touch my hair. No, white friend, not every black person has an opinion of Barack Obama. And so by diffusing potentially inflammatory situations quietly, diplomatically, with a smile and through conversation, black people in this country have benefited greatly. So I would just really right now like to take a moment of silence to the unsung heroes, to the black friends who've made America better. Okay, I think we all feel a little better now. Now I understand. Add that to our history lessons. The black friend.
Wonder why somebody threw away a new TV.
Who in the hell cares? It's ours now.
You bet your black ass it is.
Why the hell has it always got to be about my black ass? You're a bigot.
Uh-uh. I slept with a black girl 5 times in one night.
The hell does that have to do about being a bigot?
Nothing. I just like telling it again. Hey, now, where's that remote? I'm turning it on.
Hoo-hoo! Picture's great.
Yeah. Hey, now. What's this button do?
If you were my black friend, I'd never let you leave. But don't get it twisted, cause I hate slavery. Please take a chance, I can make a free throw. I even brought Cristal, did you need a Lil Mo?
Lil Mo could be my rap name, dude.
Good idea, you can join my hip hop crew.
Don't you know you're white?
Yeah, I dress like I don't. And who killed Pac, man, I'd really like to know. I can be your white friend, I even own a boat. Can't see you in the dark, you can't see me in the snow.
Black friend, you could be my black friend.
A pack of menthols. Say, bruh, where's the barbecue? If you were my black friend, I'd never let you go. Teach me how to gangster walk. Show me how to flow. And don't give me a Carlton, I want a basketball pro. If you were my black friend, I'd never let you go. I'd never touch your fro.
So will you be our black friend?
Please?
Hell no. Can I get my money now? Stop. Forget it.
I'm like, I'm a professional token black friend. I do that, you know? No, for real. Like, I have a lot of white friends, and I'm their only black friend. A lot of black people don't like being the token black friend. I don't know what's wrong with being the token black friend at all. The niggas in the world, they chose me, you know? Makes me feel special. I'm their LeBron. I was the number one draft pick in the Black Fan Lottery. I took my talents to Caucasia. You know? The only thing is this. White people, when you do have a token black friend, that shit is exclusive. Okay, you can't be going out in the world making new black friends behind your first black friend's back, you know? It's like you've been cheated on, you know? That happened to me. I showed up to play beer pong with the white homies. I walk through the door. There's this unidentified Negro in the corner. I was like, wow. Okay. Cliff, Todd, Jeff, over here, team meeting.
You are so hot. And I'm not into black girls, like, at all. But there's something about you.
Wait, excuse me?
Is that your real hair?
What?
Do you have Indian in your family?
You know what?
Oops, I was raised. It's black guy, come here.
Really, Keith? That's what you led with. You know what? My friend here, he got a little hung up with your beauty.
Wait, y'all are friends?
Me and Keith? Yeah. Oh, yeah, we go way back. Yeah, we was at my crib actually watching BET, having a conversation about how the black woman has an unparalleled beauty. It's second to none.
Black girls rock so hard.
And that was really sweet.
You owe me, Ryan Gosling. You owe me.
Racism insurance. For those times that you just kind of weren't thinking.
Hey, Quinta, can I ask you a question?
Yeah, what's up?
How do I know if my house is a trap house? Who is Fleek? How much should I be paying for a flex zone? What is a POP holding it down, and is it contagious?
Has this ever happened to you? Has this ever happened to you? Has this ever happened to you?
Well, I saw it on Fox News, and Fox News is right.
It's probably just because he's black.
Well, say no more. With my black friend, you can actually rent a black friend. This is 2015, people. We can literally get away with anything.
So racist and so talkative, but now with my new black friend, they finally keep quiet at family dinners.
Yes, what's up?
Ever since I got my black friend, my life has been so much better. It's like I could finally talk to girls now, and I look so much tougher.
We have so many varieties. Tough. Chill! And even gay! Call now and we'll throw in a free white hormonal teenager! Did I say free? So call now! And remember, once you go black, friend, you never go back. Friend.
Someone's flipping the channels with that remote, and they just paused their goddamn TiVo.
They would do it right when my drawers rolled up on it. Ooh, and we unfreeze. That's your white ass for hitting that button.
Why's always gotta be about my white ass?
Hello, we're a black gospel choir.
Black gospel choir.
You may have seen us used in movies that make you cry near the end.
We can make you cry.
Or singing behind white people to make them sound, well, like black people.
We can make it sound black.
Because people loved us so much, we decided to go out and spread love, peace, and harmony to the whole wide world.
Amen!
Don't touch me!
This forever.
It's over. No, it ain't forever. It's over.
It's over?
Yes, it's over.
Let me ask you something.
Over.
Let me ask you something.
What?
Guess who don't give a damn?
I've got joy, indescribable joy, filling up my heart. Oh, hallelujah! Joy, nothing but pure joy. I've got to tell it. I just want to share it. This joy I can't keep to myself. Black gospel choir.
Oh, yeah.
I've got love, indescribable love, filling up my heart. Oh, hallelujah. Love, nothing but pure love. I've got to tell it. I just want to share it. This love I can't keep to myself.
Oh, yeah. Wow! Thank you, Black Gospel Choir.
You're welcome, white singer.
Oh, you're the best.
So remember, wherever there's anger, discord,
or white people singing,
the Black Gospel Choir will be there to make things right.
Black Gospel Choir.
Today,
We went out onto Hollywood Boulevard and asked people, do you have a black friend? Now, the way this works is we're going to see someone introduce himself or herself, and then based solely on that introduction, together we will guess if they have a black friend, okay? You got it? All right, our first pedestrian is...
My name's Brian. I'm from Tustin, California.
Do you have a black friend?
All right, does Brian have a black friend? Yes! Already the country is divided. Well, let's take a look.
A black friend, of course.
What's his name?
His name is Alan.
There's no Alan. Come on. Is there an Alan? All right. That's Brian, and who do we have next?
Hi, I'm Tracy from Sydney, Australia.
Do you have a black friend?
Oh, interesting. From Sydney, does Tracy have a black friend?
No.
Why not?
There aren't that many in Australia.
Would you like a black friend?
Yeah, of course.
I think maybe we made a love connection right there. All right, who is our next white person?
Chuck Pruitt from Lancaster, Ohio.
Do you have a black friend?
Does Chuck Pruitt have a black friend? Yes. Mostly yeses, but said fairly softly. Okay, does Chuck have a black friend?
Black friend, yeah.
Name this person.
Black friend, let's see. Who would that be? Actually...
I think we're gonna call that a no. By the way, he's still standing out there trying to come up with a name. Next up.
I'm Nicolette, and I'm from New York.
Do you have a black friend?
Do we think... Yes. Nicolette? Everyone says Nicolette has a black friend. Well, let's find out.
I do have a black boyfriend.
All right, you're cool. Check out. Thank you.
She gets double points for that. Who else do we have out on the boulevard?
Linwood from Virginia.
Do you have any white friends?
Oh, does Linwood from Virginia have any white friends? He does. All right, let's see.
No, not really.
Why not?
I don't know. Wipes are kind of scary.
Hard to argue with that. And finally.
Hi, Isabel from New York City.
Do you have a black friend?
Does Isabel? Everyone, pretty much everyone says yes, except for one woman.
Yeah.
What's their name?
Tyrone.
Is it just one?
No, I have a lot of black friends.
Prove it.
How?
Are they in your phone?
Yeah.
Yo, Tyrone, hello? Tyrone, hey, what's happening, man? You black? Are you black? All right, cool, sweet, peace. Thanks, you have a good day.
All right, well, that was very thorough. Poor Tyrone had to be very confused.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Yes! All right, I got Shoney. Woo!
They know I suck at basketball, right?
If you could time travel to any decade, what would it be?
1950. Ooh, 1920.
1890. The future. Limited options for me in the past.
All right, well, I'm going ahead this way.
Cool, man. I'll see you.
Peace out, fam.
It feels a little forced.
Goodbye would have just been fine.
Hairless one.
I'm going to need a minute.
Okay, I'll get Froyo and be back in 20 minutes.
Okay, cool. My honey mocha or mocha honey?
Oh, and when I come up in the place and you fill it with the bass, everybody's in your face like, where's the mace? Does nobody knows this?
No one knows this song?
No, I don't, sorry.
Popping song right now.
It sounds super popping.
Cheese.
Thanks, man.
Appreciate that. Check this out.
But this is some white people music.
What?
I said I love you.
I love you too.
But this is straight white people shit.
I need some more blind.
You think you Caucasian?
What?
Yeah, you think you Caucasian?
You better get. do you think you Caucasian?
Do you think you Caucasian? Why you got some white hair?
Oh my goodness, Lord Jesus. This is blind hair, Mariah.
Then why do you have black hair like you think you Caucasian?
Mariah, this is blind hair.
Why do you think you Caucasian?
Get out of here, Mariah.
You think you Caucasian?
Move, get out.
You is brown. You think you Caucasian?
Mariah, I know what color I am.
You think you Caucasian?
No, I do not think I'm Caucasian.
You think you Caucasian?
I just said no.
Well, I think you are.
I don't think I'm Caucasian, Mariah.
Why do you have white hair?
It's blonde hair. It's not white.
Why do you have white hair? You was African America. What's you doing white hair?
Mariah, you better get out of my face. First of all, it's called African American, not African America. I know what I am.
Why is you Caucasian and you think you Caucasian?
I don't think I'm Caucasian.
Well, why do you have Caucasian hair? Oh.
Little girl, you better Caucasian your butt out of my face. I know what color I am.
Well, you should not be wearing Caucasian hair.
Mariah, this is not Caucasian hair.
That's in your hair.
Mariah, I don't think I'm Caucasian. I know who I am, okay, little girl?
Why do you have white hair on?
Mariah, black people can wear white hair too, okay? All Caucasians was not born with blonde hair, honey. So do not get it twisted.
They always wear some white hair.
But they were not all born with blonde hair, sweetie. You not what?
Caucasian.
You what?
I said I'm not Caucasian.
I know you're not Caucasian. What are you? What are you? Tell me what you are.
African America.
African America? That's not how you say it, Mariah.
Well, how you say it?
African American.
I'm African American.
You're black. I think we both know that.
No, I'm not black. I'm brown.
Okay.
I have white hands. So I'm Caucasian.
So. You are African American, okay? You're black.
No, I'm not black.
What are you, Mariah?
Brown.
You're brown, okay? You are a brown African American.
Hey, look at my hair.
Okay, you're a brown African American. You are not.
My hair is black. Your hair is supposed to be black. You're not supposed to be wearing wigs.
Oh, Jesus, take the wheel.
You are not influence me. I am my own person. I am a strong black woman.
My uncle always said, it ain't over till the beaver wields its cleaver.
What the hell does that mean? Jeez.
I'm on my way in now. I'm in kind of a bad area, okay? All right, bye.
Yo, can we holler at you for a second?
I don't have any money. My credit cards are all protected.
Yeah, but your style is whack, son.
And we're here to thug you out.
Yo, what's good? It's your boy B Dog.
Yo, baby, and I'm Dog Dog. And this is Thug Out.
Now, I mean, it's the show where we bum rush your ass and totally thug out your style. See, it's the difference between acceptable modes of fashion and straight up thugging, doesn't
it? Yeah, man. And we got a real challenge today, man.
Rule number one, learn to get your ass beat and never be afraid of that shit again. How's your chin, man? Good? You cold? Help him up, dog.
That was hard, man. Get you hard.
Huh?
Rule number two, man. An ass whooping is never far away.
Get your ass up, son. Huh? We'll keep doing that shit until you jump bad with us. Son. You
no,
jump
please, please. Bad with us. Seriously, stay away.
What? You touch me again, I'm gonna kill your asses.
Snap! Snap!
Rule number three. Learn to intimidate. Next lesson is, learn to use your words effectively.
Now, what the fuck?
Verb.
Yo, I'ma fuck you up.
Adjective.
That shit is fucked.
Damn.
I don't know.
Good, man. You can't use fuck to modify a verb.
If you try, you'll sound stupid as a motherfucker, son.
And now, the five ways to say the word bitch. Go!
Bitch!
Biatch!
Yacht!
Bitch! Bitch!
Yeah, that was excellent, man. Remember, we need to deal in misogyny to hide our own male insecurities or homosexual tendencies, as the case may be.
And you know who you are, sir.
And lastly, we modify the look.
Bam!
Yeah,
yeah, you ready, Larry?
My name ain't Larry. It's L Train. You mock ass bitches.
The fuck you say, nigga?
No, he's ready, man.
My bad. Show it.
We're gonna see what Larry's new thug life is like right after these messages.
And now, since we never see Asians in American movies or television, it's time for another moment in The Secret Lives of Asian People.
Man, work was hell today.
Really, what happened?
Same old crap, you know?
I'm in a Cherokee med school.
Oh, that's great. Way to go.
See, honey, things are looking up.
Yeah.
Do you need your pants taken in?
There you have it. Asian people are as boring as the rest of us. Join us next time on The Secret Lives of Asian People.
Yeah, back in the building, yo. About to check on Larry's thugging ass, you know what I mean?
Yeah, L-Train's up in there representing the thug way of life.
Let him know, White Pac. Let him know. We about to see how far that thug life get his ass in corporate America, though.
Bitch!
I got my ass fired today.
Congratulations, son.
Yo, thugs don't have jobs like this, yo. We work the street block.
Yeah, shit, I don't need no J-O-B, you know?
We know. Come on,
sir, talk
about the blaze.
Tune in to Thugged Out next week for our special episode, Congress, International Hoes and Domestic Bitches.
This is outrageous. That last skit is typical of how the media romanticizes the lowest levels of culture to say that it is preferable to be a shipless, lazy thug as opposed to a respectable businessman caters to this stereotype. What? I am not afraid of...
Yo, we be right back.
Get your ass out of here, man, for real.
This isn't even my shoes, man. You know, you can't trust these hoes.
You can't trust hoes.
Whoa, man, you can't say that.
Why not?
Because we're talking about black hoes. Now, we can call black women hoes.
Yeah.
But you can't.
I just thought I couldn't say nigga.
Oh, don't say nigga like I can.
The hell is wrong with you, man? You cannot use the N-word. It's not covered in your policy, man. Oh, yeah, you on your own, huh? Hey, man.
You fucked up.
Please don't jump me. Please.
We not gonna jump you. What do you think this is? We're in Westwood, man.
Yeah, bro. We just gonna intellectually denigrate and scold you for the abuse of your white privilege.
What's white privilege?
Racism insurance. For everything but the N-word.
Really?
I wanna learn! I wanna learn!
I will not lose. We gotta work on that. That's black friendship 101.